Last week, I was invited to Boeing South Carolina at Charleston to see their operation. This is also in conjunction with the world's first Boeing 787-10 delivery to Singapore Airlines. First, let's look at the Dreamlifter. Four modified Boeing 747-400 jumbo jets, called the Dreamlifter, carry the 787 parts and assemblies between Japan, Italy, Wichita, Kansas, North Charleston, South Carolina, and Everett, Washington. These big airplanes carry three times as much cargo by volume as the standard 747-400 freighters. I started my day with a media tour from the meeting room, which has an amazing view of the final assembly line of Boeing 787. I'm also going to show you the final assembly of Boeing 787, the midbody operation where they build the mid fuselage, the aftbody operation where the aftbody and tailcone is built, and Boeing Interior Responsibility Center where they manufacture overbeams, etc.
I guess, like, you know, real quick, tell us the advantage of a 787. If you have a customer, you want to buy the 787, what would you tell them?
It's the best passenger experience for passengers, the most fuel-efficient airplane for airlines, and it can take people anywhere they want to go. So that's what right. I would tell people if they wanted to buy a 787.
Yeah, how long it took from scratch to build a 787?
You know, Sam, that's a really hard question because it's not like buying a car, like you go to a car dealer and there's a car sitting there.
No.
And say, I want that car. We work with our customers. They plan out over years, even decades, what their fleet wants to look like. And we plan with them when to give them the airplanes that's the most advantageous for them. And every airline has a different interior. They have different options. They want the airplane exactly the way they want it. So it's a long process. And depending upon when they need the airplanes and what they want in the airplanes.
So guys, behind me is the Boeing South Carolina plant, the Boeing 787 final assembly line. So the plane were all built here, the Dreamliner, especially the 787-10, only built in South Carolina in Charleston.
This factory, less than a decade ago, was marshland. And so I am certainly excited to have the opportunity to lead this factory and walk in every day and see the progress we've made. When I think about nothing existed here about a decade ago to where we are today, it is really, really exciting. Back in 2011, we opened final assembly in April of 2011. In September, we began the build of the first 787, and then we rolled that out in April of 2012. So just 7 months from starting the 787 here in Charleston to rolling out, and that was a big day. And then today, here we are getting a chance to celebrate delivery of our first 787-10 with Singapore. So in this final assembly, we have about 1.2 million square feet. So that's about 10 American football stadiums, 1.2 million square feet. We have eight positions. We break our buildup into positions. So we start here with position zero, and we move down to the end of the factory for the third position, and then we have position four through seven on the other sides. So our forward section, which also consists of the cockpit, comes from Wichita, Kansas. Our midbody rolls right from the other factory across here. Delivered in midbody are sections, and you'll have a chance to see that from Italy and Japan. And then, of course, we build from carbon fiber the aft body here on site. The wings come from Japan, as well as wingtips from South Korea and parts all over the world. You know, it's the one place here in Charleston, in Boeing, South Carolina, where we can talk about the 787 from freezer to flight. Currently, we are building at 12 a month 787s. We will be moving to 14 a month in 2019. We have a really strong partnership with our Everett team as well. We have one production system, one build plan, And of course, it is certainly important for us. We have one certificate and we deliver a high quality product to our customers.
This is the heart of the program. Every single, it takes shape here. And then from here, once the airplane's painted, tested, we will fly some sections to Everett. Same thing, we put it on the Dreamlifter. So as you see right here, this is the wing box. Down in final assembly, they're gonna take a wing and attach it to it. So that is the backbone to the wing to attach to the airplane. And in this cell is where we start putting all the electrical wires, some of the systems. So there's about 76 miles of electrical wire that goes into a 787, roughly. So it's all gonna happen in this cell. So they start putting all the electrical wires and systems like ducts and hydraulic runs, waste tubes, and air conditioning type of duct. So anything that has to do with a system, it happens in this cell.
So in aftbody, this facility, it's two parts, a composite facility and an assembly and installation facility. We start our composite build using this quarter inch composite tape. And I'm gonna pass this around, you'll feel it, it's kind of tacky. It's resin infused carbon fiber. And if you look down on one of these machines, this is an automated fiber placement machine. It places this, it's called toe, quarter inch toe. If you look, you'll see that there are a number of these yellow spools in this box. That is a temperature controlled, humidity controlled environment that keeps that carbon fiber tacky so it doesn't dry out. The carbon fiber, those the 32 of those spools, feed through that machine to the orange head, the end effector. It feeds all 32 plies, toes, up to that head, such that when it lays composite material on the mandrels, the barrel section, it's laying down an 8-inch swath of composite material. And we wind that around the entire barrel, whether it's a 47 section or a 48. So section 47 is the aft passenger compartment, and then 48 is where the horizontal stab, vertical fin attach to the airplane. To get this surface finish that doesn't look like this composite tape, we add a layer of a electric discharge cloth. So if lightning strikes the airplane, it dissipates. And then also surfacer, so you can have a nice smooth surface finish to paint. So this facility does all of the composite work and all of the assembly and installation work for all aft bodies, dash 8s, dash 9s, and 10s for the entire program.
So every aft body is built here?
Every aft body is built in this facility. All right, so after we've come out of the autoclave, you have a completed structure for the exterior skin. We have a trim and drill machine that cuts out all of the cutouts in the airplane, whether it's the horizontal stab cutouts or if on a 47 section, all the passenger windows, the passenger door entry, bulk cargo door. Again, at the end of this process, now we have a finished barrel that has all the skin that we use to drill and fasten all those, again, internal hoop frames to section 48. And it's called the quad bot because we have 1, 2, 3, 4 independent KUKA robots integrated by electro impact. They did the end effector design, and it drills, selects the right grip length fastener, seals it, and inserts the fastener. So we load our floor grid next. The floor grid comes as a pre-assembled module. It's rolled into the barrel, and it's mechanically fastened to the frames to the edge of the floor grid itself. And then after the join process, we go to the right side of our factory. And the right side is where we do all of our systems installation.
The Interiors Responsibility Center team fabricates and assembles 787 Dreamliner interior components, including storage bins, closets, partitions, ceiling panels, class dividers, overhead crew rest, video control station, and flight attendant modules.
Well, I hope the video gives you an insight into Boeing South Carolina 787 operation. Thanks to Boeing team there for the tour, and it's always a pleasure to share the video with you.